office that I think fit well into this idea that trying to capture the sensation of the moment when they were working from the landscape. When I talk about sensation, I'm talking about how they utilize marks and describe, like, oh, is there wind going through the trees? Is it a cold, blustery kind of wintry day, as this first slide presents, right? That's where I'm going with it. Maybe it isn't. Maybe it's just the artist messing around. But what I get out of this is a wintertime landscape. There's a wind happening, and it feels kind of cold, and the sun is kind of muted in there because of what's happening up in the sky. So you can see that they are more concerned with trying to capture a sensation than describe the landscape in a real literal type of way, meaning like here's a tree, here's branches coming off a tree. They're seeing it in a different way, right? So there's the first one. Here's the second one. Let's zoom out a little bit. There we go. Now, this has got India ink, probably willow, probably some compressed in it. And once again, it's about that sensation. And what we see up in here is a cloudy day, and then maybe the sun trying to bust through the clouds up in here. There's a tree line in here. And once again, there's no or brambles or just small, low-growing bushes, but there's no leaves on it. And so I think late fall, early spring, with this happening up in here, with this sun trying to bust through these clouds. Very free, very, very free in here. And I would love for some of you guys to go after something like this or something like the previous one, all right? Now let's go to number three, which is this guy looking at a mountain. Could be a Katahdin, could be, what do you call it? The ski resort up there, up north, whatever. I can't remember the name of it right now. Sugarloaf. All right, so once again, look at how free these marks are up in here. They're talking about the sensation of this mountain coming out of the ground here, out of the regular plains or whatever is around it. I love these. Look at how loose these clouds are up in here, right? Very, this is a wet on wet. So they might wet the paper first and then put down a gray India ink, and it'll bleed out like that along the edges, right? Over in here, it's the same thing, but the paper's probably a little more drier in here. And some, when you're doing that, I will show you that in how to control the India ink in some of the videos. There is a couple videos that I posted already that have the India ink in it. So there's tons you can do with India ink, right? All right, that's number three. Now number four. And again, a wintry day. Right? Moody, very moody here. There's not a lot of detail in here. It's more like, okay, this is a wooded area with some trees coming up and some branches coming off. Wooded area over here, a path or a field going up to, looks like a lone tree right there back in the background there, right? Very soft, very moody. You can tell they're not really into the detail. They are more into capturing the sensation of that moment in that landscape. All right, number five is right. Now, these are, I picked them and put them in order because, trying to show how you can start to control this mark making. So here we have another landscape, a house, structure, whatnot, with a big chimney over here. Maybe it's wintertime, maybe it's mud season in the fall, in the spring. And so look at what happens here, an overall value going on in here and a texture right back in here too. And that helps this lighter area in here glow in a certain way more so because they have the soft grays below it and around it in spots. And then the dark forms of the structures, buildings, whatnot up into the sky, and it gets darker up at the top of the paper, and it's some clouds in there or mist or whatnot. But this area right in here really starts to glow. And again, if you want to go after something like this, I'd love to see it, right? Number six, all the way down to the bottom. Now, here's another pen and ink, maybe, pen and ink, and I think maybe a bamboo pen or something, because see these marks over in here? That feels like it's the side of a pen, and he's scraping on it and trying to pick up the texture of the paper by how he uses the pen, not the tip of the pen, but the side of the pen, and creates that value, that rough texture. Tons of information in here, right? Tons of information. But I also think that he doesn't like overdo it. He just lets it be. Boom, boom, we can see the house in here. And then there's all these ship boats in here with the small masks coming up. The bridge or causeway way in the background. The tree over here. And I just love the energy and enthusiasm of working through this drawing, right? Now, where were we? 6 to 7, right here. Now, this, I love this guy because of the subtle grays in between, the subtle grays that happen down in here and the darks that happen in here, which are really actually minimal. And so now I'm wondering, when I look at this guy, I wonder if they used a gray India ink, which would help making those softer grays, because I feel like there's a white pigment in here, but I'm not sure. It might be also the paper that it's drawn on. It might be more like a parchment or a vellum. I think that might be it, because I think the India ink sits on the vellum in a different way. So anyway, these grays in here are so beautiful. And then he gets leads up into these darker areas, which really are accents or exclamation marks, and really set off this area down in here in relationship to this up in here. I love how this drops back underneath, right? It might be tracing paper on top of tracing paper. Excuse me. So that's a possibility. Let's go to number 8. I think you're going to love this one, right? Fingerprint and landscape. This is like really wonderful. And look at how much work it is in here to build up this fingerprint tech pattern. And goes lighter over here, heavy in here. And then he did all this work. They did all this work to build up the shadows and whatnot. The shadows and the grass and the tree line. I'm loving this idea. This is a wild idea. Right? So once again, structure, satisfying the equation of structure and freedom. How do you want to describe what you're looking at? Well, if there's a sensation here, I can't help but to think this person is sitting here. If that's his fingerprint, right, then they are kind of saying my fingerprint's left on this landscape. I'm here. I was here when I drew this. I love this for that reason. Number 9. Landscape drawing number 9. Now, there we go. Birch trees, right? Now, let's zoom in a little bit and take... There we go. Now, I'd love for somebody to go after this. Because, you know, look at what's happening in here. Just all these birch trees lined up in a row, but they're not all, like, even. They overlap. They go at diagonals. They go at opposite diagonals. As they drop back into space, they get a little darker in spots, right? But the... Oh... kind of overall pattern is through all of them, but not repeated, just the idea. And so it does say birch trees, a grove of birch trees in here, a dense grove of birch trees. I think that's a wonderful drawing too. And the last one, right? So we're in here, representational. The other ones were more, expressionistic, right? And so here is one, the last one we'll end up on, is one where I go like, okay, yep, all right. So the sensation of a landscape. So here's all these trees lined up in a diamond shape, right? The artist lets us know this is a diamond shape by doing this. The landscape around the trees is a little bit barren. Inside, there's not much going on inside except for the grass, right? Grass out of here, and it looks like well-worn on this side. As if somebody's like walking back and forth up and down in here. Maybe patrolling this area to make sure everything's nice and orderly in here. Right now, that's just my reading of it. But I'm wondering what you guys think about it. I love how this sky drops back behind this diamond shape. And there's one other thing I wonder about. If this is gridded out like that on the paper, or if these are sheets of paper that are sitting next to each other, where they did the drawing and put it together. And if that's the case, let's think about this. 18 by 24, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in there, does it look like? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's 8 by 8, right? 18 times 8, 18 times 24. That's a big drawing. Right? You guys can do the math. I'll figure it out later. But I love this one too because of just the conceptual take on it and the formal play between the diamond shape here and all these textures and the repetitiveness of the trees growing in here, right? The light's coming forward, the darker one's dropping back. And what was I saying? Oh, the formal elements in here and how they work with the conceptual take of it, of like somebody's walking in along the edges of this to make sure everything's fine in here, right? I hope these give you ideas about what to do for your final set of landscape drawings. All right, once again, any questions, concerns, reach out to me. All right, see you later.